My research aims to design next-generation structural alloys that, for example, we use in the body of our cars, in the engines of our spacecrafts, in our biomedical implants, or all the way down in microelectronic devices. We aim to design these alloys to have higher performance, because in this way they last longer in service and we do not need to reproduce them, which consumes a lot of energy and also causes significant CO2 emissions. Therefore, we want to contribute to material sustainability. We are especially interested in designing additively manufactured structural alloys. This is an emerging and, in fact, rapidly emerging technology, and there are several methods in that. One of the methods is laser powder bed fusion. That in how we manufacture the alloys is that there is a powder, and there's a powder bed stock, that one layer of powder is spread, then there is a laser which melts the required area, another layer of powder is spread, and then in this way you build your component layer by layer. In my group, we are designing these alloys virtually in the computer. We are connecting these processing parameters to what you can see under the microstructure of these alloys, and then by knowing these microstructure features, you can predict the properties. So we are not only interested into designing these alloys to have reliable properties, but we are also exploring some designs which shows unprecedented properties compared to traditional manufacturing like casting. When we finish the design virtually, we really manufacture 3D printed these alloys because we want to validate the design in the experiment. We will perform mechanical tests on them and either revalidate the design or we get feedback for redesigning the alloy and repeat the cycle one more time. Another unique opportunity by additive manufacturing, which is designing gradient alloys. Imagine previously with traditional manufacturing like casting, if you wanted to design the blades of a jet engine, you require different properties at different sections of this blade. Where the blade is connected to the disc, you need high fracture toughness because otherwise there will be a rupture. So the person who wants to design should find a magical composition which satisfies all these properties because he had only one choice. But with additive manufacturing, we have this unique opportunity that at the voxel size resolution of these components, you can change the composition and the microstructure. Therefore, you can tune the design depending on what you need at that location of the blade. As the next thrust of my research, we are interested in studying these alloys in harsh environment because in critical engineering application, usually this is the condition, for example, hydrogen corrosive environment. So to study how these alloys will behave under hydrogen corrosive environment, we look at microstructure of these alloys at atomistic scale and we charge hydrogen atoms into the microstructure and we study how they influence the properties and we try to find solutions to prohibit these detrimental effects or resolve them. In all these research areas, we have a lot of processing parameters, a lot of alloying elements in the composition that can go up to 20 number of elements. Exploring this design space is very challenging for the human mind. So how should we find the critical elements? We get help in my research from artificial intelligence to guide us to explore this high-dimensional space and also to help us find the critical elements. And this working of artificial intelligence interacting with the researcher will shorten the time for the design and make our design more efficient.